back to my channel. Jenah here with another video, and today we have a DIY crafts video, if you will. I am not known for doing arts and crafts, but I have that big IKEA mirror that everyone has, and I hate silver, so today we're spray painting it gold. Before we get into the video though, go ahead and click the subscribe button, like the video, leave any of your questions, comments, concerns down below, and now we can get into the video. So I saw someone else do this and I was like, I can totally do this. And my mom gave me the go ahead to do it in my room because the mirror is so big and so heavy. I can't just take it back down the stairs and hope that I don't ruin my floors. Yeah. So the first thing you're gonna need for this project is some gold spray paint. I got this shade of gold, looks a little bit darker on camera, but it is a true metallic gold and it's from the brand Rust-Oleum. Then you are also going to need some painter's tape. This is just some blue regular painter's tape in order to put down the plastic onto the mirror. Next, we have this plastic drop cloth that I am going to also put down on the mirror so that the glass does not get spray paint on it. So this is just some plastic. It's the very small roll. It covers about 108 square feet, so should be enough for this, but we'll see. And then the next thing you're gonna need is some general all-purpose masking paper. You're gonna need this in order to put it on your floor if you are doing it on a surface that you don't want to ruin. And then of course you also want to wash the mirror down because spray paint does not stick to dirt. So I have this Dawn liquid dishwashing soap, and then I also have some Windex for the actual mirror, and then two separate washcloths for both solutions. So I'm just gonna set you guys up on the floor and you can just watch me do all this. And we're just gonna hope that it turns out good. I guess I should. How the f did I get Christmas tree on the mirror after washing it? It's so hot. Next, I'm gonna take this, I'm out of breath. Yeah. Such a weird time to ask for Windex because I never have the Windex. Anyway, I'm gonna take this painter's tape and I feel like there's a little groove under the glass. So I'm gonna try my best to get it as close to that as possible. I guess it would help if I cut it in a straight line. This is a very not good situation. I am inexperienced and this is a pretty cheap mirror. I just don't want to have to buy another one because it was so hard trying to get it in my car by myself. Yeah, there we go. Smart of me. Okay, so next I have to take this stuff and I have to put it on top of the mirror across and tape it down so that again nothing gets on the mirror. I'm confused. I feel like this is, oh, well, this is gonna be fun. I don't know exactly how this is gonna happen just yet, but we are going to. Like, what am I supposed to do? Cut it? I'm so confused. It's like a trash bag. I need my mop. The guy in the video just made it look so easy. I don't understand. Like, is there a way to be lazy with this? Like, if I just... Imagine I just did all of this and I still get a whole bunch of spray paint on the mirror. Like, I know it's not likely, but I just feel like this is a little excessive for spray painting. I just don't think it has to be perfect. So we're not going for perfect here. We have long since left the path of perfect. Right now it's just, we gotta get it done because I have to get ready for a Christmas party. All right, you guys, so next, I have just put on all the tape and the plastic so it doesn't get on the glass. And now I need to pick this heavy mirror up by myself because everyone just left the house somehow, and get this underneath it so that I don't spray paint my actual floor. And I don't think it's really gonna take much. So I think I'm literally just gonna slip it under the mirror as much as I can. And then I'll double layer it and then just maybe like tape it so that it doesn't get on my actual floor. But I don't think I'll even need to do that. I think it'll only take me just doing a little bit. So that's what I'm gonna do now. My only thing is it's just a little bit thin. Oh God. So it looks like I have sufficiently done what I needed to do. So next step, I'm just gonna spray paint because it's been that long. I just need it to be done. Kind of over it at this point. That took so long and it's gonna take me like 5 minutes to spray paint. So I'm gonna read these instructions. Remove, shake hand vigorously for 1 minute. Shake often during use. 10 to 16 inches from the surface. Please hold, I think I need to put more of this down. Dry in a steady back and forth motion, slightly overlapping each stroke, keep the same distance. Okay, for the best appearance, apply one light coat followed by one wet coat. Okay. I don't know how long a minute is, but. I don't know what 10 inches looks like, but we're gonna do whatever this is right here. Oh. Is that getting on my floor? I hope that's just air. Maybe it's turning off my fan. All right, I don't know if you can consider that a light coat, but it looks pretty light to me. Okay, so I think I finished, but I do have the window open in my room and the fan on because when I came back from washing my hands, it just looked very dusty in here. So the window is open for ventilation to get over whatever is in the air out. I'm guessing it's just like, what is it called, aerosol in the air, but I see sparkles flying everywhere. So I'm just like, oh my God. So I'm gonna leave this covered for a while, probably until I get back from the Christmas party tonight, which will be late. So I'll probably just keep it covered overnight, let it completely dry. Let's see if I can show you guys a close up. So like you can see right here, like that may not look so great because it's just gonna probably dry like that. But to me, that's not really a big deal. It's fine. But like this is what it's looking like so far with the gold, and I wanted to make sure that I really got all of the edges. So yeah, that is what it's looking like right now. Like I said, I am going to let it dry and just kind of sit there. There are sparkles on my
that on the screen, but it doesn't look gold, so maybe it's not. Maybe it's just the sparkles, which is still annoying, but. And I'm gonna check back in with you guys once I kind of let this dry a little bit more, and maybe I'll apply one more coat if needed, maybe tomorrow. But I kind of need to get out of my room because the smell is intoxicating. Okay, you guys. Hi. It's been a few days since I've completed this project, and I put the mirror back on the wall where it belongs. So I wanted to just show you guys what it kind of looks like after the fact. It looks amazing. I do feel like maybe a little bit it's very neutral in my room, but that's because my room, like the color of my walls is like a nude color, and my bed is like also nude, and like I love gold, and everything's just very neutral in my room, so it does blend in. But in terms of the color, I think the only reason it blends in so much because the silver stood out to me like a thumb sore, because I just really hate silver. So I think that's why the gold just looks a little bit more normal to me, if you will, because that's what I'm so used to. But I did want to show you guys what it kind of turned out like. I turned off my ring light so that you can see maybe a little bit better. This is what it kind of looks like. I obviously need to wipe down my mirror. I haven't used any Windex on it since I've done it. Yeah, maybe there are a little bit of flaws just because it was on my floor and my floor is so plush. The cardboard type of waxy looking kind of paper, if you will, was up against this, so it is so in some spots it may be a little bit more silver or a little bit more like gritty. Like here, I feel like maybe I could have done a little bit better of a job, but it doesn't bother me. I got the gist of what I'm looking for, and I can always re-coat it if I need to in the future. Right here, you can kind of tell what I'm talking about in terms of like rigidness and the texture, and I think that is only because of my carpet, and then I had that paper pressed up against it, so maybe it was a little bit more wet right here and it dried a little bit more textured, more 3D, but not too much of an issue to me. I think overall this turned out really, really well. I'm super excited about it. I really love the color of it. I will leave the products that I use down below if I can find all of them, or I will link a similar product so that you can maybe do this task too. Everybody and their mama has this mirror from IKEA. It's like $120. I really wanted this mirror to, I just feel like the gold makes it look a lot more expensive. So yeah, I'm really happy that I did this. I will also leave down below the video of the guy who first did this project, the video that I used for context in order to do this as well. That is the end of the video. That is my little DIY project. Not sure if you got anything out of it or if you liked it. I don't do DIY projects very often, so don't expect this from me. I'm not good at it at all, but this is a project that I wanted to take on, and I'm so happy that I did. I think it looks so good, and I can't wait to like move out and move into my new place and have this mirror. I just think it's gonna look so good. So if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, leave any of your questions, comments, or concerns down below. Also go ahead and follow me on my Instagram @xjenah, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye everyone.